Sweetheart, I bring you another good news. I have been promoted again. This time, with greater benefits.
Wow. Good news. This calls for celebration. I am so excited. Do you have cold?
Not really, just... My chest is hurting me, Catherine. Please, take me to the hospital.
You are scaring me, Chris.
Hospital, Catherine. I feel like I'm about to collapse.
Doctor, my husband Chris. How is he? You guys have been moving around without telling me anything. What's wrong with Chris?
How do I explain this? Can't we go to my office, please?
We are having this conversation here. Where is my husband?
Mrs. Catherine, I want to be completely transparent with you. He's in a very severe state right now. What happened came on suddenly and without any prior warning signs, which has surprised us as well. Your husband suffered what appears to be a massive heart attack, and it's very serious. The chest pain he experienced was an indication of this, but unfortunately, it quickly led to cardiac arrest. Right now, our team is doing everything we can to stabilize him and keep his heart functioning. He also showed signs that might point to an aortic dissection, which can be equally dangerous. Please understand, this is a life-threatening situation. We're throwing all of our resources at it to give him the best chance possible, but it's critical. We'll continue to monitor him closely, and we'll keep you updated on every development. I know this is overwhelming, but we're here for you and doing everything in our power to help him.
Doctor, my husband was hale and hearty before leaving the house in the morning. We usually come for regular checks. You've never told us this before. Where is this coming from?
I honestly don't understand. He's currently on life support. We will try our best. Just be prayerful.
How? How can this be happening? You were fine just a few hours ago, we were fine. You left the house this morning, full of life, strong, healthy, and now? How could someone so full of life, my love, be lying here like this? You even came home to share the best news, smiling like always, telling me how everything was going to be perfect. This doesn't make sense. This can't be real. Just this morning, you kissed me goodbye and promised me today was going to be a great day. You can fight this. You have to fight this. I need you. I don't know how to live without you. I'm too young to be a widow. We have so much left to do together, so many dreams, so many plans. I can't lose you. I just can't. Please, baby, please come back to me. I need you to survive this. We've been through so much together, but I can't face this without you. I won't make it. I need you to wake up, to be strong, for us, for me. Don't leave me here, alone. Not now. Not like this. You promised me a future. You promised me forever. Please don't break that promise. I need you, more than I can say, more than I've ever needed anyone. Please, God, let him survive this. Please don't take him from me, not now. Please let him come back to me.
Mrs. Catherine, I am so sorry to tell you this, but... he really struggled to survive. We tried our best, but God knows and understand. We lost your husband.
This is not possible. Chris cannot die. You are a liar. Where is Chris? What kind of evil dream is this? Please, how's my husband now? He's responding to treatment, but he's not stable yet. We are doing our best. I need to go somewhere. I'll be back, please.
Please, I'm here to see Chris. I learned he is on admission here.
Who are you to Mr. Chris, please?
I am his wife's elder sister. She went home and she called me to stay here pending the time she comes back.
All right, I'll take you to him. Although, he's in a critical condition. You're only going to see him and sit outside his room.
That's fine by me. Thank you. This is just the beginning. You'll lose everything and I'll render you useless. By the time I'm done with you, you'll plead for death. Queen Mother. I bring you good news. He's finished. The fool that dared marry my sister, his fate is sealed. 3 days, just 3 days, and he will draw his last breath. No doctor, no prayer, no miracle will save him from what we've woven. I'll laugh at her tears, at her cries for help when no help will come. When the fruit rots on the tree, does the tree not wither away with it? So shall she wither, watching her love fall to the grave. The one who plants flowers in the midst of thorns should know the thorns will choke them. She thought herself safe, thought her prayers would protect her, but I am the thorn that will choke her hope. She doesn't even believe in our power, the fool. But I will be the end of her, and she will know. When her husband's life slips away, when the shadows close in around her, she will understand. No one escapes the grip of the coven. Not her, not him, not anyone. Even her precious God will turn his back on her. For who can save her now? Not even heaven will reach for her, for I have already claimed her. I am the shadow, and I own this world. The earth bows to us, and she will too, in her despair. No one can save her. Her fall is written, her doom is sealed. And I will dance on the ashes of her misery.
Sharon speaks truth. We hold a power that shakes even the most arrogant of souls. The so-called Christians with their prayers and crosses? They crumble at our feet, their faith like dust in the wind when we move against them. They may shout and chant, but it is we who command the darkness. It is we who decide who stands and who falls. Anyone who dares cross our path, anyone who stands in defiance of our will meet the same end. It matters not what they believe, or how loud they pray. We are the rulers of this world, and our grip is unbreakable. We own the night, the unseen forces that bend to our command. No God, no faith, no man can stand before us without tasting defeat. Let it be known, we will deal with anyone who thinks they can challenge us, anyone who dares oppose the coven. They will fall, one by one, like leaves before a storm. We are the storm. We are the ones who hold true power, and the world bows to us. And those who think they are untouchable, like that fool husband and his wife? They will learn, there is no escape from what we have claimed. We decide their fate now. And their fate is ruin.
O spirits of the shadows, hear us now, the dark realms guide us. Power is ours, we rule the skies, we cannot be defeated. In the darkness, we reign, we shatter the light, we break the chains. Corruption of the soul, all names of virtue will crumble. No one above, no one can. All shall fall beneath our power.
O ancient power, mistress of the world and secrets of destruction, we are the rulers, and forever we will reign. Blood will flow into the earth, and our strength will grow. There is no salvation, no faith, except in us, the rulers of the night. The heavens will not hear them, even God himself will be silent. We are the gods of this world.
Catherine, your family is under a heavy witchcraft attack, and it's no coincidence. You let your guard down. The fame your husband achieved blinded both of you. You once stood as a prayer warrior, but you allowed comfort to weaken you. You stopped seeking the face of God as you used to. Where is the Catherine who was always on fire for the Lord? You have distanced yourself from his presence. That is why the enemy found it easy to strike. You let the enemy in because you stopped praying and lost the spiritual discipline that kept your family covered. You stopped coming to church like before. Don't you see this? You must reclaim your mantle, Catherine. The authority, the power that you once walked in is still yours. You need to rise up and fight for your family. The witches who have dared to attack your home think they own your husband's life, but they don't know the God we serve. You must fast for 3 days, and during those 3 days, call on the Holy Ghost with power. Chant his name in warfare. Cry out to God to break every witchcraft chain that has bound your family. Catherine, I tell you, the weapons of our warfare are not carnal but mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds. Do not be afraid of their power, for the power of God in you is greater. Bind every spirit of death and destruction that has touched your husband's body. Pray like the warrior you once were. I will join you in prayer, and you will be amazed at the outcome. But you must do this with urgency and with all your strength. If you truly want your husband alive, rise now and take back what the enemy has stolen. Let every witch know they have no claim over your family. The Holy Ghost will fight for you, but you must begin the battle now. The Lord will restore what has been lost, but this fight starts in prayer and fasting.
Pastor, you are right, sir. We've been so far from God due to our forgotten pain. We forgot that the devil strikes back after a victory. I definitely know what to do, Pastor. God bless you, sir. Merciful Father, I come before you today with a heavy heart, seeking your forgiveness and mercy. Lord, I acknowledge that I have strayed from you. I allowed the blessings and fame you gave my family to distract me from the relationship I once cherished with you. I let pride and comfort pull me away from the altar of prayer, and for that, Lord, I am deeply sorry. Father, I repent for neglecting the place of intimacy with you, for forgetting that you are the source of everything we have. Forgive me, O Lord, for losing sight of you in the midst of the success you graciously gave us. I humble myself before you now, asking for your mercy, Lord. Cleanse me from every sin and disobedience. Restore my heart back to you, Father. Let my passion for prayer and devotion to you burn brighter than ever before. And now, in the name of Jesus, I stand in the authority you have given me, Lord. Every witchcraft power, every evil force that has risen against my family, I rebuke you in the name of Jesus. I declare that you have no power, no authority over my life or the life of my husband. You have tried to control us, but you are not lords over us. Only Jesus is Lord over our lives. Every curse, every attack of the enemy is broken right now by the blood of Jesus. I call down Holy Ghost fire upon every witch, every agent of darkness that has targeted my home. Let their plans be destroyed. Let their weapons be shattered. You spirits of death, sickness, and affliction, I command you to loose your hold on my husband. He will not die but live to declare the works of the Lord. Father, I speak life and total recovery over my husband in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, I declare that every witchcraft power assigned against my life and my family is utterly destroyed by the fire of the Holy Spirit. I command every witchcraft altar where my name or my family's name has been raised to be consumed by the consuming fire of God. I declare that no enchantment, no divination, no spell has any power over me, for I am covered by the blood of Jesus. Every weapon of witchcraft fashioned against me is broken and rendered powerless now. I decree that every force of darkness sent to manipulate or control my destiny is cast down and bound in Jesus' name. The plans of witches and warlocks are shattered, and their evil works are returned to them sevenfold. I stand in the authority of Christ and declare that only God's will shall prevail in my life. Every witchcraft attack sent to afflict, delay, or destroy me is rendered null and void. By the name of Jesus, I walk in divine protection, and every spirit of witchcraft must bow to the Lordship of Christ. From this day, I am untouchable by any force of darkness, and my family is delivered from every witchcraft scheme. In Jesus' mighty name, I declare victory. Amen.
Doctor, Mr. Chris' oxygen level is dropping. We need to do something. His heart rate too. I'm afraid.
Let's go. Get ready for CPR.
Watch, as he bids the world farewell.
Holy Ghost fire, scatter their camp. Holy Ghost fire, destroy their plans. I summon the fire of the living God to burn through every witchcraft stronghold now. Let the voice of God thunder against the gathering of witches. Let confusion fill their ranks. Let their tongues be divided, and let them fight one another until they are no more. In the name of Jesus, I release confusion into the camp of the wicked. As it is written, the Lord will cause confusion among them, and they will turn on one another, 2 Chronicles 20:22. So shall it be in the midst of every witch and warlock that rises against me. By the power of the Most High, let their charms turn to ashes, their curses to blessings, and their dark schemes to foolishness. Let their wickedness boomerang back upon their own heads. I call upon the Lord of hosts. Arise, O God, and let your enemies be scattered. Let them melt away like wax before the fire. Let their wicked plans be crushed under the weight of your glory, in Jesus' name. As you did in the days of Jehoshaphat, O Lord, cause utter confusion to reign among the forces of darkness. Let them turn on one another until none remain. Your word declares that no weapon formed against me shall prosper, Isaiah 54:17, and I stand victorious in Christ. Confusion is their portion, and destruction is their end. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen.
What is happening? This power, it's not from us. It's like everything we've worked for is unraveling.
I don't understand. I felt our grip on them tighten just days ago. This isn't possible. No one challenges us like this. No one.
But it's her. It has to be Catherine. I can feel it. Her prayers, her God. She must be calling on him. It's breaking through, tearing at our power.
We control the darkness, the very shadows bent to us. How can? How can this be? How could their God? No, this isn't right.
Could it be? After all these years of power, is their God truly greater than anything we've known? This confusion. It must be him. We're losing everything. Our curses, our dominion, crumbling. We mock them. We mock their faith. But look at us now. We're helpless, confused, broken. I can't deny it anymore. God. Their God, he is powerful.
I hate to admit it, Sharon, but he is strong. Stronger than we ever knew. We thought ourselves invincible, but...
How did it come to this? We never believed. We never thought their God could touch us. But now... I see. He's beyond what we imagined.
In all our pride, we underestimated him. This confusion is his judgment, his power. Even we cannot stand against the God of all creation.
He's greater than all we've ever known. We can't deny that anymore. We've been defeated, not by men, But by God, why are you so powerless? You deceived me into joining this society. What a waste.
How dare you? I'll crush you to death. How dare you call me a waste? You're evil, a wicked sister. I'll show you the reason why I'm called Queen Mother today.
Jesus Christ. What is this?
Catherine, I need to tell you something. I'm the reason you've suffered, the reason your husband is lying there like this. All of it, it's been me. I've hated you, Catherine. I've hated you for years. I couldn't stand to see you succeed while I struggled. How could my own younger sister be more successful than me? How could you dare to get married before me? You had everything. A good husband, money, fame, every good thing life could offer, it came to you, not me. And I couldn't take it. You never said no to me, never held back from me, even when I hated you. Every time you gave me what I asked for, it infuriated me more. How could you be so perfect? How could you have everything and still be so good? I've been a monitoring spirit in your life. I knew everything happening with you. I watched you rise higher while I stayed in the shadows. My hatred grew, and I turned to darkness to bring you down. I cursed your happiness. I cursed your marriage, your peace, everything. I wanted you to fall. I wanted to see you lose everything. I thought if I could ruin you, I would finally feel like I was better than you. But now I see. I see that no power, no darkness, is greater than the power of God. The coven. It's in disarray. Everything is falling apart. Our Queen Mother. She's dead. And I know my doom is here. I can feel it. I'm going to die, Catherine. There's no surviving what's coming for me. God has judged me, and there's no escape. No witchcraft, no spell, no darkness can stand before him. I was blinded by hatred, by envy. But I see now that I was wrong. I thought I could take everything from you, but in the end, God took everything from me. There's no power greater than His. I was a fool to think I could fight against Him.
Chris.
This is me, Catherine. I'm fine, perfectly fine. Jesus healed me.
Thank you, Jesus. This is God's miracle, Chris. But, something happened. Chris, I have only heard of witches and witchcraft attacks in movies and storybooks. I never believed they existed. This is so surprising.
Catherine, I never would have imagined your own sister could harbor such darkness. A monitoring spirit, a witch, it's hard to believe. But above all, we must give glory to God. He has fought this battle for us. Without His protection, we wouldn't have survived this. We didn't know, but God knew, and He shielded us. As hard as this is to accept, we must remember, to forgive is divine. God calls us to forgive even when it seems impossible. Let's draw even closer to Him, pray more effectively, and trust that He will continue to guide and protect us.
Amen. Doctor said he has never witnessed such miracle as yours before. He said your oxygen level was dropping and you rose up yourself. I am so happy. I'll never give up on thanking God.